The Philippines expands its rollout of second COVID-19 booster shots. The health department says adults 50 years old and above and individuals aged 18 to 49 who have comorbidities may now receive a fourth jab, but only using the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines. They are also only allowed to get a second booster dose 4 months after receiving their first one. Previously, only health workers, senior citizens, and immunocompromised individuals were eligible. Medical certificates will not be required to avail of the second booster. According to the DOH guidelines, a medical screener or doctor at the vaccination site is authorized to assess and make the determination.
The Philippine government launches its new COVID vaccination drive. The health department says the Pinaslakas program will focus more on improving booster uptake to increase the immunity of those who've already been vaccinated. It aims to administer the first booster shot to at least 50% of the eligible population and fully vaccinate 90% of senior citizens. The DOH is confident it can hit its target of 23 million vaccinees in the first 100 days of the Marcos administration.
Marami na rin tayo nakausap na local governments, and actually, sabi nga nila, hindi nyo na nga kailangan magkampanya pa dahil ginagawa naman natin. Kailangan lang talaga pag-igtingin, kailangan lang talaga minsan kalampagin, ano, tsaka para magkatulong-tulong tayo lahat.
Makakapaghanap buhay po tayong lahat ng mas ligtas na may bawas na pangamba. Magiging mas ligtas ang pagbabalik eskwela ng ating mga anak. Manunumbalik po ang turismo at mababawasan po ang pangamba sa paggamit ng public transportation.
The start of the booster drive comes as the Philippines logs another 2,360 COVID-19 cases. This brings the number of active infections to more than 27,000, the highest since April 10. Based on Health Department's latest projections, daily cases may reach 19,000 by the end of August. But it could slow down to between 6,000 and 8,000 if vaccination and booster rates are improved.
If we observe right now, our cases are continuously increasing, but in spite of the continuous increase in the number of cases here in the country, we are seeing that the severe and critical cases are plateauing, meaning it's not going or it's not increasing, and our hospital admissions are not also increasing. Though there are areas in the country right now that we are closely monitoring because we are having increase in the number of admissions, but upon checking and upon analysis, we are seeing that because the admissions are because they have low number of beds that had been allocated for COVID-19.
The Philippine Health Department is dismayed over a new measure that lowers the age of access to vaporized nicotine or vape. DOH officer in charge Maria Rosario Vergere vows to continue informing the public about the harmful effects of vape and non-nicotine products. The bill lapsed into law on Monday, a month after then-President Rodrigo Duterte failed to either sign or veto it. The highly contentious measure faced heavy opposition from health groups as it lowers the age of access to e-cigarettes from 21 to 18 years old. It also transfers the regulation of vapes from the Food and Drug Administration to the Trade Department. Senator Pia Cayetano, who actively opposed its passage, also expressed her disappointment. She says she'll continue to fight for Filipinos' health and well-being, even if it means going up against strong lobbying of industries.
The Senate minority bloc launches a new bid to free former opposition Senator Laila De Lima from detention. Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, Risa Ontiveros, and an unnamed colleague from the majority bloc co-authored their first resolution in the 19th Congress. They urged the Justice Department to drop the illegal drug charges against De Lima and set her free. De Lima is a staunch critic of former President Rodrigo Duterte's war on drugs. She has since been detained since 2017. Her lawyers believe the cases against her should now be dismissed as several key witnesses recount their testimonies.
Basically, in-enumerate yung nakaraang kalahating dekadang mga karanasan ni Sen. Leila hanggang sa pinaka-recent na may hindi kukulang sa tatlo na nag-recant na sa kanilang mga pagsasaksi laban sa kanya.
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rebullo meanwhile maintains that the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Courts have sole authority to order De Lima's release. Rebullo adds they will rely on the discretion of the courts on the appreciation of evidence presented against De Lima.